Good morning, everybody. Wherever you are, whether you're watching live or on catch-up, I shall say konnichiwa to those in Japan, kia ora for those in New Zealand, and welcome to today's Healing Minute from the virtual Harry Edwards Sanctuary. I'm John, speaking to you today as usual from Hillingdon, West London, where it's a bit grey and a bit overcast. But I do need to warn you that if you hear a loud noise, please ignore it, as we're on the flight path of Northolt Airport, and it'll be a large plane or a helicopter. The music you're listening to is by Aeolia, and the CD is entitled Angel Love and the track Celestial Sanctity. I want to thank you all for joining us for the Healing Minute today. This session includes an opportunity for each of us to send healing love not only to ourselves, because the healer needs to be strong, but to all those, the people, the animals, and all sentient beings on our own planet we know are in need. Today's session is entitled Aspiration. I'll explain that as we go through the various processes. And we're going to stop the music now as we begin to prepare to send out our healing love to the universe and the sentient beings that we know are in need. In preparation for the Healing Minute, please close your eyes if it is safe to do so. In your mind, take yourself off to your own personal sanctuary, somewhere that you feel perfectly safe, totally at ease, and completely peaceful. We start by taking a deep breath and inhale the healing energy and allow it to flow through our body from the top of our head to the tips of our toes. As we breathe out, we let go of all our personal stresses and any dis-ease in our own body and lives. The picture you're looking at, by the way, is of a bust of Harry Edwards. It was given to him on his 80th birthday by the National Federation of Spiritual Healers, now known as the Healing Trust, at a fabulous ceremony which I regret I wasn't at. But it was his 80th birthday and they had a gathering of over 5,000 people at the Royal Albert Hall. And needless to say, he did do demonstrations of healing. But back to where we are seeking to be this morning. Let's enter into the attunement with our spiritual realms and our guides and doctors. We give thanks that we are gathered here today. We ask that this place be filled with love, light, friendship and healing energies. Surround us in protection as we open our hearts and expand our consciousness to allow the flow of love and healing to come through us. As our crown chakra opens, we visualize a column of pure white light filling our body. Then feel the balance and harmony within our body as the earth energy rises up through the soles of our feet and our base chakra. We feel our connection to the universal source of pure, unconditional love, balanced by the nurturing, protective love of Mother Earth. Today I'd like to read the sanctuary prayer. Heavenly Father, I surrender myself to the good influencing of your healing ministers in spirit, that through your divine healing power, the disharmonies within me might be overcome and the stresses of mind and body be eased and lessened day by day. Help me to adopt a more positive and helpful way of thought. Bring me into closer harmony with those around me and with the divine healing purpose. And for those who are sick or in the darkness of despair, who do not know of the help that can reach them from spirit, I pray that awareness will come to them soon, that they too might experience the upliftment of spirit that can lead us all through harmony towards true health. May God bless you all. Amen. I'm now going to read Touched by Angels, which is a little prayer that my dear friends Alan and Tracy favour. Touched by angels, we are touched by angels and walk where angels tread. They will guide us, walk beside us through the days ahead. In the hours of darkness, when our dreams have flown, they bring hope and gentle healing. We are not alone. In our times of doubting, still they understand, and forever touched by angels, we walk hand in hand. The Great Invocation. This is going to be the focus of the reading after we've sent out our healing, because this is an aspiration for an upliftment of the spirit of the entire planet and all its creatures and people. So let's dwell on the words in this. From the point of light within the mind of God, let light stream forth into the minds of men. Let light descend on earth. From the point of love within the heart of God, let love stream forth into the hearts of men. May love return to earth. From the centre where the will of God is known, let purpose guide the little wills of men. The purpose which the masters know and serve. From the centre which we call the race of men, let the plan of love and light work out, and may it seal the door where evil dwells. Let love, light and power restore the plan on earth. We now enter the healing minute. We ask now that all the people and animals whose names we hold in the distant healing folder may receive healing for their highest good. We also request healing for their family, friends and the people who have requested distant healing. May they be placed in the healing light and receive that which they are allowed to receive for their highest good. Let us pause for a minute and send our energies to those who are in need. Thank you. Our thanks and blessings for your help here today and to our friends in spirit. Today's reading is about the prayer that we often say on these healing minutes and which I came across personally about 35 to 40 years ago when I first entered spiritualism. It is something that is universal. But let's look at its history and its origins and what it means. Firstly, I've got to give you a warning that the information I've gathered is from various sources and may well be flawed. And if there's any errors, I apologise, and please let me know if I've got it wrong. On that note, I owe an apology. My dear friend Rowena pointed out that Vincent and Jean Hill were married in the sanctuary, and they were the first non-family members to be married at the sanctuary. The first ever person to be married at the sanctuary by Harry was in fact his daughter, Felicity, who was a marrying Mr. Medland. But now, on to the topic of today. The Great Invocation is a world prayer, an invitation for light, love and enlightenment to the world. It is used globally as an act of service to humanity, to aid the plan of God, or gods, as Dave Allen, the Irish comedian, would say, to find full expression on this wonderful planet of Earth. There are at least two versions. The original version, released in April 1945, as it was given to Alice A. Bailey and her husband Foster by the Tibetan master Jiwal Kul. I apologise if I pronounced that wrong. The timing was considered to be appropriate after the devastation globally of World War II. But there is also a newer adapted version to accommodate the world's changing consciousness, issued in 2000 by the Lucius Trust and supported by the United Nations. Lucius Trust was formed in 1922 in New York by Alice and Foster Bailey. I now like to read you the wording from a leaflet which my wife obtained from the NFSH, now the Healing Trust, about this document. We probably acquired this sometime in the 1980s. But here we go. The Great Invocation is a world prayer, translated into over 80 languages and dialects. It is an instrument of power to aid the plan of God to find full expression on earth. To use it is an act of service to humanity and the Christ. It expresses certain central truths which all men and women innately and normally accept. That there exists a basic intelligence to whom we give the name God. That there is a divine evolutionary plan in the universe, the motivating power of which is love. That a great individuality, called by Christians, the Christ the World Teacher, came to earth and embodied that love, so that we could understand that love and intelligence are effects of the purpose, the will and the plan of God. Many religions believe in a world teacher, knowing him or her under such names as the Lord Maitreya, the Imam Mahdi, and the Messiah, and many others, of course. The truth that only through humanity itself can the divine plan work out. By means of invocation, prayer and meditation, divine energies can be released and brought into activity. Men and women of goodwill, of many faiths and nations, can join together in world service, bringing spiritual value and strength to a troubled world. They have the power, through focused, united invocation, to affect world events. Knowledge of this fact, scientifically applied, can be one of the great liberating factors within humanity. No one can use this invocation or prayer for illumination and for love without causing powerful changes in his or her own attitudes and life intention. As a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. Will you use this invocation every day with thought and dedication? We do at the sanctuary. The effect of individual prayer and invocation for light and love can be immeasurably increased when there is conscious recognition and relationship in thought with all who use the Great Invocation. So that's the thought process behind it, and it's something I certainly subscribe to. Now I shall read to you the revised version, which was approved by the United Nations in the year 2000 and I think I shall continue to use this in future, and would encourage everybody else to. From the point of light within the mind of God, let light stream forth into human minds. Let light descend on earth. From the point of love within the heart of God, let love stream forth into human hearts. May the coming one return to earth. From the centre where the will of God is known, let purpose guide the little human wills, the purpose which the masters know and serve. From the centre, which we call the human race, let the plan of love and light work out, and may it seal the door where evil dwells. Let light's love and power restore the plan on earth. By reading this invocation daily, we seek to link with attuned minds across the world to focus light and healing energies to those who are in need of help and enlightenment. That is the aspiration, or the first part of today's aspiration. We seek to bring love and light, and of course healing, to all those who are in desperate need, and goodness, don't we need it right now. I hope you found that of interest. Next time, which is Thursday, 12th November, I've been shuffled on the rota. I should be asking a question, and I propose to try and answer it. And that question is, was Sherlock Holmes a medium? Enough of me. Now time for parish notices. The Healing Circle, which we started on the 1st of October, will have another event on the 1st of November on Zoom at 7:30 p.m. and the special guest will be Linda Sewell. The Zoom master, as always, will be our wonderful Teresa, who makes magic happen digitally. The Healing Minute tomorrow is by our wonderful friend Alan, who will be in Reading, not in Spain, so suffering the same weather as all in the UK at the moment. And the Cygnus Cafe will be held next Wednesday at 10:15. And we will have the pleasure again of Mari Davis, I hope I pronounced her name all right, who is a very inspirational lady. And of course, all the links to these are now fully up on the Harry Edwards website. So you just need to click join us on Zoom for that particular one. So I'm going to say farewell and thank you for spending so much of your valuable time with us for the benefit of others who are in need. Anyone who has received healing from the sanctuary will, as you know, remain on the distant healing list for 1 month. But if you wish to renew it, contact us, which you can do by email, letter, phone, Skype. Do phone our lovely receptionists, they love a chat. And if you require distant healing for yourself, please contact us in the normal ways. We are still open for contact healing, but it's in a COVID-secure, precautionary manner. But it still works. And the healing, the absent healing, which Harry always used, also works. Please never underestimate the power of absent healing. All of our past events are now available on our website, YouTube, Facebook, and lots of other digital things. Today's music is again inspirational. This is a song written by a group called Odyssey and was published in 1977. And it is aspirational for a young man. I like to think it is about basketball player in America. And this is entitled Golden Hands.
Michael has golden hands, and he'll shoot his way down.
Thank you so much for joining us today. Please stay safe and healthy. I love that tune. It always makes me feel very emotional. Stay safe, and I'll see you on Thursday, the 12th of November.